When working with TI devices, it's necessary to review the TI datasheet. TI datasheets can be found on TI.com. Measuring linear amplifier characteristics such as common mode rejection ratio can be a challenging task. In this training, we'll talk about how to quickly analyze CMRR as defined by the TI datasheet. Before we begin, it's important to note TI provides additional training material online. These online resources are TI Precision Labs regarding common mode rejection ratio, TI's Analog Engineer's Pocket Reference Guide, and a training on the ABA swap process. In addition, TI provides free simulation software known as Tina TI, which can be downloaded at the web address provided. There are various electrical parameters for a linear amplifier that are defined in the TI datasheet. To make testing these parameters more efficient, a test loop can be utilized. For this example, we will use the false summing junction. The false summing junction, as shown in the upper right-hand corner, helps to measure VOS. The benefits of the false summing junction are that it's simplistic and its size is small. This is mainly due to the fact that there are only four resistors required to measure the majority of DC parameters for a linear amplifier. In an amplifier, offset voltage is defined as the differential input required to force the output to mid-supply. VOS is best measured at the summing junction node, mentioned as V sub J of S. In addition, this slide provides an equation to define the offset voltage. This equation is derived directly utilizing Kirchhoff's voltage law using the schematic provided. In this example, we see the amplifier's offset for the given conditions is approximately 10 microvolts. Before we measure CMRR of a linear amplifier, let's define common mode rejection ratio. Common mode rejection ratio is defined as the change in offset voltage divided by the change in common mode. It's important to review a TI datasheet and its test conditions prior to analyzing any parameter. This includes evaluating CMRR. In this example, we will use the OPA192. It's important to note that the OPA192 is a rail-to-rail complementary input amplifier, which has three operating regions. These operating regions are defined as the PMOS region, the NMOS region, and lastly, the transition region. Please refer to the figure for a visual representation, as operating in the transition region may impact CMRR. As the common mode is shifted within the PMOS region, you see that the common mode rejection ratio, or the change in offset, is linear. However, operating in the transition region may impact the results because the change in common mode has resulted in a change in the offset, and the slope has shifted. Now that we've defined common mode rejection ratio, let's review the test conditions to measure common mode rejection ratio in this example. In this demo, we will measure CMRR, but it's important to note that we can measure CMRR and shift the common mode simply by shifting the supplies and output voltage as defined in the figures provided. For offset voltage number 1, the supply conditions will be positive 30 volts and 0 volts. Remember, the output must be at mid-supply, in this case, 15 volts. For offset condition number 2, the supply conditions will be positive 3 volts and negative 27 volts, with the output at mid-supply at approximately negative 12 volts. Now let's verify common mode rejection ratio of a linear amplifier as defined by the TI datasheet. In this example, we will use the OPA192. In addition, we will make use of a universal prototyping board known as a breadboard. In addition, we will use two power supplies and a digital multimeter to read the output voltage of the false summing junction circuit. Let's first begin with measuring the offset voltage in our first supply condition. In our first supply condition, the positive voltage is at 30 volts with the negative at 0 volts. Remember, the output voltage must be shifted to mid-supply. The output voltage of the false summing junction is approximately 121 microvolts. Entering that into our spreadsheet, we see that the offset of the amplifier is approximately 1.19 microvolts. Now that we've measured the first offset condition, let's change our supply conditions and measure the offset in condition number 2. But first, we must turn off our power supplies. Now that we've adjusted our power supplies for the second offset condition, we see that the positive supply is at 3 volts with the negative supply at negative 27 volts. Remember, the output must be at approximately mid supply, in this case, negative 12 volts. In this condition, the output voltage of the digital multimeter is approximately 769 microvolts. Entering that into our spreadsheet, we see that the offset voltage of the amplifier is approximately 7.6 microvolts. Therefore, the common mode rejection ratio of the amplifier is approximately 132 dB. 132 dB is within the specification outlined by the TI datasheet. I've shown you how to measure common mode rejection ratio for a linear amplifier. It's important to utilize the TI datasheet when analyzing electrical parameters, as the TI datasheet provides the test conditions for each specification. For TI datasheets, please refer to TI.com. Thank you for watching this troubleshooting video.